So good afternoon, everyone, all of you who have joined us online. So today is the first class for the chanting sessions that AFMG is about to commence. And I'm Dr. Omkar. I'm here to actually take the first session of pharmacology, which will mainly focus on general pharma, ANS, and we'll try to cover CVS as well. These sessions will mainly focus on the one-liners, the important topics, the high-yield points, and the previous year questions. Right, and please, though you are sitting online over there, please try to repeat these things after me. If I'm making you repeat this, so it will be more effective. And please try to answer in the chat box too. So that would be more helpful for all of you. Okay. So let's begin with the session for today. So khana kha ke aaye ho sab log? Yeah. So you should be loud and clear. Okay. कोई दिक्कत नहीं है इफ यू फील स्लीपी टेल मी एंड द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग अगर कहीं भी लगता है इफ यू वॉन्ट मी टू रिपीट एनी थिंग प्लीज टेल मी एट द सेम पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम सो वी कैन रिपीट इट देयर इटसेल्फ द फर्स्ट थिंग सेकेंड इफ यू वॉन्ट टू रिवाइज समथिंग मोर नंबर ऑफ टाइम्स दैट ऑल्सो कन्वे टू मी जस्ट रेज योर हैंड एंड आस्क दैट डाउट ओके सो नाउ स्टार्टिंग विद द फार्माकोलॉजी चैंटिंग फ्रॉम टुडे द फर्स्ट टॉपिक दैट वी आर अबाउट टू कवर इज जनरल फार्माकोलॉजी Right, general pharmacology usually has dry questions from it. Okay, usually we will have definitely one-liners or graphs from general pharmacology that will appear in the examination. ठीक है? So general pharma is an important topic because general pharma और कहीं भी किसी भी और subject में cover नहीं होगा. That is the reason you need to study general pharma well in pharmacology itself. ठीक है? So now the first question is fraction of a given dose which reaches the systemic circulation is known as shabash. It is not just a minute. Let me make it thicker. It is known as bio. Are you able to see it properly? Yeah. So it is known as bioavailability. ठीक है? So again, fraction of given dose which reaches systemic circulation is known as. This definition had come earlier. Okay. Fraction of given dose which reaches systemic circulation is known as. Which route of drug administration has 100% bioavailability? Shabash. In intravenous route, the drug is directly injected into the circulation. Therefore, intravenous route will have 100% bioavailability. Okay, important one. Next question is, most important factor in distribution of a drug is? I hope you know that drug has two ways. That is pharmacokinetics and pharmacodynamics for its metabolism. फार्माकोकाइनेटिक्स में चार प्रोसेस होती है अब्सॉर्प्शन डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन मेटाबॉलिज्म एंड एक्सक्रीशन राइट सो आई एम आस्किंग यू व्हिच इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट फैक्टर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ अ ड्रग कोई तो बोला इट इज लिपिड सोल्युबिलिटी इंपॉर्टेंट याद रख लेना द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट फैक्टर फॉर अब्सॉर्प्शन ऑफ अ ड्रग इज मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट फैक्टर फॉर अब्सॉर्प्शन ऑफ अ ड्रग इज So if the drug is more lipid soluble, it would be distributed more inside the body. ठीक है? So most important factor for drug distribution is lipid solubility. Important thing. इधर ही एक बात याद रख लेना. The drugs which are water soluble, will be excreted out via kidneys. Drugs which are water soluble, they will be excreted out via kidneys, and therefore they should be contraindicated in. Shabash. They should be contraindicated in renal failure because in cases of renal failure, if these water-soluble drugs are given, they may lead to accumulation of these drugs because the kidney is not working and that can land up into toxicity. Okay? So water-soluble drugs are contraindicated in renal failure. Important. Next question: Maximum volume of distribution is seen with which drug? Maximum volume of distribution is seen with the lipid soluble drug. I am asking the drug name which has maximum volume of distribution. VD. Maximum volume of distribution is seen with chloroquine. 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 And chloroquine is the drug of choice for malaria in pregnancy. Shabash. So please remember, chloroquine is the drug of choice for. Chloroquine is the drug of choice for malaria in pregnancy. ठीक है. So which is the drug of choice for malaria in pregnancy? Chloroquine. Okay. Chloroquine was also used as a prophylactic measure for which disease? अभी जो आया था epidemic. COVID. Okay, chloroquine or hydroxychloroquine was also used as a prophylactic or a preventive measure for COVID-19. Yaad rakhna. Moving further, which is the most common? Ek second, thoda volume kam kar. Which is the most common conjugation of phase 2 reaction? Shabash. So yaad rakhna, drug has two phases of reaction. That is phase 1 reaction and phase 2 reaction for its metabolism. ठीक है, so in phase 2 reaction, phase 1 reactions will break down the drug and phase 2 reaction will conjugate the drug, किसी और के साथ जोड़ देगी. ठीक है, so which is the most common conjugation of phase 2 reaction? Glucuronidation. Which is the most common conjugation of phase 2 reaction? Glucuronidation. Important thing. ठीक है, एक बार फिर से revise कर लेंगे slide. Fraction of given dose which reaches systemic circulation is known as? Which route of drug administration has 100% bioavailability? Intravenous. Most important factor in distribution of drug is? Maximum volume of distribution is seen with which drug? Chloroquine. Chloroquine is the drug of choice for? Malaria and pregnancy. And a prophylactic measure for? COVID-19. Which is the most common conjugation or phase 2 reaction? Glucuronidation. One important thing from general pharma as well, that is first pass metabolism. Okay, first pass metabolism is the responsibility of which organ?
Liver.
So before the drug reaches systemic circulation, okay, it is metabolized by liver. So for example, 100% of a drug was given, out of which 20% was metabolized by liver. This is known as first pass metabolism. Then only 80% of the drug has reached the systemic circulation. Okay? So this is first pass metabolism. Now a question which can come, which is the route of drug administration which has highest first pass metabolism?
Nitrates.
It is oral route. Yaad rakhlo, oral route of drug administration has the highest chances of first pass metabolism. So highest first pass metabolism is seen with which route? Highest first pass metabolism is seen with which route? Oral route. Important one. Moving further. Now talking about the excretion of the drug. Okay. So excretion of drug can occur via two kinetics method. Okay. So first is known as first order kinetics and the other one is zero order kinetics. First order and?
Zero
order and? First order kinetics. So most of the drugs will follow first order kinetics. Most of the drug will follow first order kinetics. But some of the drugs are there which will follow zero order kinetics. Please remember, in zero order kinetics, the rate of drug elimination is constant. The rate of drug elimination is? So what is constant in zero order kinetics? Rate of drug elimination. What is constant in zero order kinetics? Rate of drug elimination. Important thing. ठीक है, याद रखना. So, which are the drugs which will follow zero order kinetics? So, we have a mnemonic for it known as zero watt power. Okay, zero will tell us about zero order kinetics. W goes for?
Warfarin.
W goes for? A goes for? Alcohol and aspirin. The A goes for? Alcohol and aspirin. T goes for?
Theophylline.
T goes for? Theophylline. I am writing like this. ठीक है, यही PDF मिलने वाली है, so you need to adjust with this. So T goes for? Theophylline. And last T, second T goes for? Tolbutamide. Second T goes for? Tolbutamide. Second T goes for? Second T goes for? So don't forget it. ठीक है, ढंग से लिख लेता हूँ. So second T is for tolbutamide. ठीक है, and power goes for phenytoin. Power goes for. So अभी एक बार revise कर लेंगे. ठीक है, so zero order kinetics is followed by which drug? What is the mnemonic?
Zero
watt power. Zero for zero order kinetics. W for? W for? A for? And alcohol and?
Aspirin
and? T for, second T for, power for phenytoin. So याद रखना, these are the drugs which will follow zero order kinetics. Okay, where the rate of elimination is constant. Moving further now. So the drugs, if they want to act on any particular cell or a tissue, they need to bind to the receptors. So we have various types of receptors, out of which, please tell me, which are the fastest acting receptors? Ion channels or inotropic receptors. Okay, which are the fastest acting receptors? Inotropic receptors or ion channels are the fastest acting receptors. Important examples pooch sakte hai. So those are GABA A receptors, AMPA receptors or NMDA receptors. Theek hai? Which are the examples of fastest acting receptors? GABA A, AMPA and NMDA receptors. Fastest acting receptors are GABA A, AMPA and NMDA, which are type of inotropic receptors. Then we also have some enzymatic receptors. Okay, these enzymatic receptors are usually tyrosine kinase receptors. So enzymatic receptors are commonly tyrosine kinase receptors. Okay, and which are the hormones or drugs which will have these enzymatic or tyrosine kinase receptors? Mnemonic is PIG. Where P goes for?
Prolactin.
P goes for?
Prolactin.
I goes for? And G goes for? So enzymatic receptors more commonly are of which type? Tyrosine kinase receptors. And the examples of tyrosine kinase receptors are PIG. P for? I for? And G for? The answer sab log bolenge because kabhi bhi koi bhi question aa sakta hai. Theek hai? So the answer sunna bhi. Then slowest acting receptors are intracellular receptors. Please remember, intracellular receptors can be either intracytoplasmic or intranuclear receptors. Okay, slowest acting receptors are intracellular receptors. The examples of usually these intracellular receptors, is pe question aaya tha isliye bata raha hu physio se. So intracellular receptors would be for two vitamins, vitamin A and vitamin D. It would be for two hormones, T3 and T4. So thyroid hormones act via intracellular receptors, yaad rakhlo. And it would also be for steroids and sex hormones. Baki kuch yaad rahe na rahe, important one is thyroid hormones and vitamins. Theek hai, ye yaad rehna chahiye. So jaldi se, tyrosine kinase receptors ke examples are PIG, P for prolactin, I for insulin, G for P for I for
insulin,
G for
GABA.
ये question नहीं भूलना है because इस insulin पे दो तीन बार question आ चुका है, ठीक है, इसलिए revise करवा रहा हूँ. Then vitamin A and vitamin D have which type of receptors? Slowest acting, that is intracellular receptors, ठीक है. Next one. Now moving on to next question. उसके पहले one more type of receptors are usually your GPCR receptors. Those are G protein coupled receptors, which has three subunits, alpha, beta and gamma. So, ये question पूछा गया था that ATP will bind to which of the subunits?
Gamma.
ATP binds to which subunit? GTP binds, ATP or GTP can be there. So, GTP is common. Okay. So, alpha subunit के साथ कौन bind करेगा? अल्फा सब यूनिट के साथ कौन बाइंड करेगा? जीटीपी, याद रख लेना बस ये. एंड जीपीसीआर रिसेप्टर्स वीडियो में रिवाइज करोगे, दोज आर आल्सो नोन एज सर्पेंटाइन रिसेप्टर्स और सेवन पास रिसेप्टर्स. जीपीसीआर रिसेप्टर्स आर आल्सो नोन एज सर्पेंटाइन रिसेप्टर्स और सेवन पास रिसेप्टर्स, ठीक है, इंपॉर्टेंट. नेक्स्ट, मूविंग ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, दैट इज G6PD डेफिशिएंसी. नाउ ठीक है. सो जी सिक्स पी डी डेफिशिएंसी दैट इज ग्लूकोज सिक्स फॉस्फेट डीहाइड्रोजनेज. So G6PD enzyme is deficient in some individuals, and those individuals are more at a risk of causing hemolytic anemia. G6PD deficient individuals are more likely to cause hemolytic anemia. That is known as G6PD deficiency anemia. ठीक है. So this anemia is mostly due to free radicals which are generated inside the body. ठीक है. So this is a free radical induced hemolysis. ये anemia किस वजह से होता है? Due to the free radicals. So G6PD deficiency में anemia is due to free radical. So it is a free radical induced hemolysis. So some of the drugs are the ones which act as risk factor for this free radical induced hemolysis. Okay, some drugs will act as risk factors for free radical induced hemolysis. Those are remembered by the mnemonic PNS. कैसे याद रखोगे? PNS. P for primaquine. P for primaquine. N for nitrofurantoin. N for nitrofurantoin. S for G6PD deficiency पे दो बार क्वेश्चन था इसीलिए करवा रहा हूँ. ठीक है. सो याद रखना G6PD deficiency anemia में there can be exacerbation of anemia or exacerbation of symptoms if which three drugs are given? P and S. P for N for and S for sulfonamides. Can anybody tell me, primaquine is given in malaria for what purpose? Or? हाँ, so it is given for intrahepatic stage. ठीक है, very good. It is also given for prophylaxis. मुझे drug of choice किसके लिए बता दो चलो. Primaquine is used as a drug of choice for which condition? ये discuss किया था PSM में. So please remember, for relapse prevention of malaria, which is the drug of choice? Which is the drug of choice for relapse prevention of malaria? Which is the drug of choice for relapse prevention of malaria? I told you, relapses are common with which Plasmodium species? Plasmodium ovale and Plasmodium vivax. Relapse is common with which two species of Plasmodium? Plasmodium ovale and Plasmodium vivax. ये मत भूलना, ठीक है? So therefore, in cases of malaria which is caused by vivax and ovale, the drug of choice would be primaquine for relapse prevention. Which is the overall drug of choice for malaria? Artemisinin. That is artemisinin based combination therapy. ACT लिखते होंगे तुम, ठीक है? याद रखना. That will be discussed in antimicrobials. ठीक है, याद रख लो. So which are the three drugs which can lead to exacerbation of symptoms in G6PD deficiency anemia? PNS. P for? N for? S for? Primaquine is the drug of choice for? Relapse prevention of malaria. Again. Now there are some drugs which are metabolized by acetylation. Okay, some of the drugs are metabolized by acetylation. So these drugs are remembered by the mnemonic SHIP drugs. Okay, so acetylators have a mnemonic known as SHIP drugs. ठीक है, where S goes for sulfonamides and S goes for sulfonamides. H goes for hydralazine. H goes for I goes for isoniazide. And P goes for शाबाश. तो यही गड़बड़ होती है. Usually we remember SHIP. But more commonly in the mnemonics, we encounter phenytoin. तो गलती से phenytoin mark कर दिया जाता है. In exam mostly वो phenytoin ही देंगे. ठीक है? तो याद रखना, this is procainamide, not phenytoin. ठीक है? So, which are the acetylators? Mnemonic is SHIP. Which are the acetylators? Mnemonic is
SHIP.
S for? H for? I for? I for? And P for? P for? Before, भूलना मत, ठीक है? Now these SHIP drugs, which are metabolized by acetylation, they can also lead to a very important side effect. What is that? Very well, that is SLE. याद रखना, systemic lupus erythematosus is the most important side effect of which drugs? SHIP drugs. SLE is the most important side effect of which drug? SHIP drug का most important side effect क्या है? SLE. याद रखना, ठीक है? इस पे questions आ चुके. Moving further now. आवाज ज्यादा इको तो नहीं हो रही, ठीक है? मूविंग फर्दर टॉकिंग अबाउट कैट ड्रग्स नाउ, ठीक है? दिस इज वन मोर निमोनिक, कैट ड्रग्स, ठीक है? सो कैट ड्रग्स आर सी फॉर C-saprite. C for? C-saprite. A for? Astemizo. A for? Astemizo. And T for? Terfinadin. T for? Terfinadin. Nahi, terfinadin. ठीक है, don't get confused. So, cat drugs कौन से होते हैं? C for? A for? And T for? Terfinadin. Okay, so these cat drugs have a very important and a dangerous side effect. That is, शाबाश, बोलो. QT prolongation. So, they have a very dangerous side effect. That is, QT prolongation. Important. Cat drugs have a very important side effect known as cat drugs can lead to QT interval prolongation. ठीक है, and cat drugs C for C-saprite, A for Astemizole, and T for Terfinadin. Important है, ठीक है, याद रख लेना ये. QT prolongation is a risk factor for which type of arrhythmia? शाबाश. QT prolongation is a risk factor for torsades de pointis. QT prolongation is a risk factor for torsades de pointis, TDP, which is nothing but polymorphic ventricular tachycardia. Kya hai ye? TDP is what? Polymorphic ventricular tachycardia. So TDP ka important risk factor kya hai? TDP ka important risk factor kya hai? QT prolongation. TDP ka important risk factor kya hai? QT prolongation, which is caused by which drugs? CAD drugs. C for? A for? And T for? Sometimes they say CAD is cute. Okay, CAD is cute. Cute is for? Quinidine. Cute is for QT prolongation, or a drug you can remember, that is quinidine. Okay, class 1A antiarrhythmic drug, quinidine. Important question pucha gaya quinidine se, yaad rakhna. Quinidine also leads to QT prolongation. ठीक है, याद रखना ये ड्रग. अगर यहाँ पे टीडीपी की बात आ ही गई है, बताओ द ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस फॉर टीडीपी. MgSO4. ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस फॉर टीडीपी इज मैग्नीशियम सल्फेट. ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस फॉर टीडीपी इज magnesium sulfate is also a drug of choice for one condition in pregnancy, that is eclampsia. So magnesium sulfate is a drug of choice for two conditions. First is TDP. Second is eclampsia. बोलोगे? नहीं. ठीक है, याद रख लेना ये. Moving further now, pharma, general pharma से मैंने बोला कुछ graphs आ सकते हैं, okay? So we'll discuss those in images towards the end of pharma. सारे एक साथ images discuss करेंगे, कुछ 7-8 images होंगी. Okay, right now, just remember guys, if we draw a graph of dose response curve, okay, unke shapes pe question pucha gaya. Either the graph can be given and they can ask you which is this graph of, or they can ask you what is the shape of this particular graph. Theek hai, yaad rakhna. So what is the shape of a dose response curve? Dose response curve. Hyperbola, yaad rakhlo. What is the shape of a dose response curve? What is the shape of a dose response curve? What is the shape of a dose response curve? Hyperbola. Whereas, what is the shape of a log dose response curve? Sigmoidal shape. ठीक है, what is the shape of a log dose response curve? Sigmoid or S shape. जल्दी से, shape of DRC? Shape of log DRC? भूलोगे? नहीं. सिग्मॉइड किसका शेप है? और हाइपरबोला किसका शेप है? डीआरसी का, याद रख लेना. ठीक है, इंपॉर्टेंट. नेक्स्ट, इफ आई टॉक अबाउट पोटेंसी, ठीक है, सिग्मॉइड इज दिस, ऐसा वाला. ठीक, सो नेक्स्ट वन इज पोटेंसी. पोटेंसी मीन्स पावर ऑफ अ ड्रग. पी फॉर पोटेंसी, पी फॉर पावर ऑफ अ ड्रग. ठीक है, पोटेंसी इज डिटरमाइंड बाय द साइड ऑफ द ग्राफ. पोटेंसी इज डिटरमाइंड बाय द साइड ऑफ द ग्राफ. दैट मीन्स लेफ्ट साइडेड ड्रग इज मोर पोटेंट. लेफ्ट साइडेड ड्रग वुड बी मोर पोटेंट. लेफ्ट साइडेड ड्रग इज, ठीक है, दिस क्वेश्चन हैज कम. दे हैव गिवन यू अ ग्राफ इन विच यू हैव ड्रग ए एंड बी. ड्रग ए इज ऑन द लेफ्ट साइड, ड्रग बी इज ऑन द राइट साइड. सो नाउ टेल मी विच इज द मोस्ट पोटेंट ड्रग. लेफ्ट साइड, दैट इज ड्रग ए विल बी द मोस्ट पोटेंट ड्रग. ठीक है, याद रखना. पोटेंसी इज डिटरमाइंड बाय द साइड ऑफ ग्राफ. पोटेंसी इज डिटरमाइंड बाय द whereas efficacy is determined by the height of graph. याद रखना, potency is determined by the height of graph. जिसकी efficacy is determined by the height of graph. Efficacy is determined by the height of graph. जिसकी ज्यादा height वो ड्रग उतनी ज्यादा efficacious होगी. ठीक है, याद रख लेना. So height of graph determines height of graph determines whereas side of graph determines. ठीक है, बोलना. Then if we talk about the slope, okay, the one more feature that we can see in a graph is the slope. ठीक है, so if the slope of the graph determines what, first of all, safety. S for slope, S for slope, S for safety. So slope of the graph determines
safety.
Slope of the graph determines safety of a drug. Slope of a graph determines safety. याद रख लेना. ठीक है, if the graph is having a steeper curve. If a graph is having a steeper curve like this, it would be a safe or unsafe drug?
Unsafe
drug. Shabash. If a drug is, if a graph is having steeper curve, it would be a? If a graph is having a steeper curve, it would be a? And if a graph is having a flatter curve, it would be a? Safer drug. If a graph is having a flatter curve, it would be a? Steep curve?
Unsafe.
Steep curve?
Unsafe.
Steep curve?
Unsafe.
Flat curve?
Flat
curve. Slope determines
safety.
Potency determines potency is determined by and efficacy is determined by. ठीक है, याद रख लेना. Then moving further, I hope this is clear with you. Graphs अगर आए तो गलती नहीं होगी अभी. Moving further now with therapeutic drug monitoring. Okay. So therapeutic drug monitoring मतलब क्या? You will actually check the levels of the drug in your circulation. Okay, those drugs should be in a recommended level of recommended level in your plasma. Because if those drugs go beyond the point of beyond the point of recommendation, then it can lead to toxicity immediately. Okay, याद रख लेना. So usually therapeutic drug monitoring is drugs having low therapeutic index. जिनका narrow therapeutic index होता है ना, उनमें usually we recommend therapeutic drug monitoring. Because if a drug is having a narrow therapeutic index, that can definitely very rapidly escalate to toxicity. Okay, so the mnemonic is the same. Therapeutic drug monitoring is done for a drug possessing low therapeutic index. Therapeutic drug monitoring is done for a drug possessing low therapeutic index. Therapeutic drug monitoring is done for a drug possessing low therapeutic index. Where A goes for antibiotics. A goes for antibiotics. D goes for digoxin. D goes for digoxin. Possessing P goes for phenytoin. P goes for phenytoin. L goes for lithium. L goes for lithium. T goes for tricyclic antidepressant, TCAs. And I goes for immunosuppressants. I goes for
immunosuppressants.
So therapeutic drug monitoring is done for a drug possessing low therapeutic index. A for
T for, L for, P for, T for, L for, T for, T for, T for, and I for
immunosuppressant. Important है, ये भूलना नहीं है. ठीक है, इस पे आ सकता है question. And that is the reason why lithium की एक recommended level है, we discussed in psychiatry. कितना होना चाहिए lithium in plasma? 0.5 to 1 तक recommended level है. And maximum acceptable value is 1.5. When lithium exceeds more than 1.5 milligram per liter or milligram percent, then it would lead to lithium toxicity, which is the most common side effect. Which is the first symptom or most common symptom of lithium toxicity?
Tremors.
Yaad rakhlo. Which is the most common symptom of lithium toxicity? Which is the most common symptom of lithium toxicity? Which is the most common symptom of lithium toxicity? Nahi bologe ye baat yaad rakhna. Theek hai, lithium toxicity is seen when the level of drug exceeds 1.5. Yaad rakhlo. Theek hai, I hope this is clear to you. Moving further. Now this was the important things that we had to discuss in general pharma. Theek hai, starting with autonomic nervous system. Theek hai, autonomic nervous system ANS will consist of two types of nervous system. First is your parasympathetic nervous system and second is your sympathetic nervous system. Can anybody tell me, parasympathetic nervous system is also known as cholinergic nervous system because the neurotransmitter in parasympathetic nervous system is acetylcholine. Therefore, it is also known as cholinergic nervous system. On the other hand, sympathetic nervous system is also known as adrenergic nervous system. Sympathetic nervous system is also known as adrenergic nervous system because the neurotransmitter secreted in sympathetic nervous system is noradrenaline or adrenaline. Okay, usually it is noradrenaline. Also known as norepinephrine. Don't get confused. It is one and the same. Noradrenaline or norepinephrine. Adrenaline or epinephrine. It is one and the same drug. Okay, yaad rakhna. Then now if we talk about the origin, okay, ek baat uske pehle clear kar lenge physio se. Parasympathetic nervous system is active in which state? Shabash. It is active in resting state. It is active in resting state. Whereas sympathetic nervous system is active in fight, flight or fright. Sympathetic nervous system is active in fight, flight or fright. Dar jaate ho. ठीक है, ये एक बेसिक फंडा है, इससे सब क्वेश्चन सॉल्व हो जाते हैं, इसीलिए से बताया. नाउ कैन एनीबडी टेल मी व्हाट इज द ओरिजिन ऑफ पैरासिंपैथेटिक फाइबर्स? शाबाश. द ओरिजिन ऑफ पैरासिंपैथेटिक फाइबर्स इज, द ओरिजिन ऑफ पैरासिंपैथेटिक फाइबर्स इज, ओरिजिन ऑफ पैरासिंपैथेटिक फाइबर्स इज आउट ऑफ व्हिच क्रेनियल नर्व 3 7 9 एंड 10 आर इन्वॉल्वड एंड सेक्रल फाइबर्स S2 S3 एंड S4. So, origin of parasympathetic fibers is craniosacral. Origin of parasympathetic fibers is craniosacral. Whereas, origin of sympathetic fibers would be thoracolumbar or dorsolumbar. Origin of sympathetic nervous cells, sympathetic fibers would be thoracolumbar or dorsolumbar. Kuch bhi bol lo. Theek hai? So, jaldi se. Origin of parasympathetic? Origin of parasympathetic? Origin of sympathetic? Origin of sympathetic? ठीक है, so बीच वाला जो portion है, this is sympathetic. ऊपर और नीचे वाला portion है, that is parasympathetic. ठीक है, याद. Now moving further, talking about the neurotransmitter, overall तो हमने देख लिया, parasympathetic में कौन सा? Acetylcholine. और sympathetic में कौन सा? Noradrenaline. ठीक है. Now if they ask you, a question has come earlier, neurotransmitter secreted by all the preganglionic fibers is shabash. The neurotransmitter secreted by all the preganglionic fibers is acetylcholine. So the preganglionic fibers, whether from the parasympathetic or from the sympathetic nervous system, all of them will secrete preganglionic fibers. Will secrete preganglionic fibers. Will secrete. Don't forget this. ठीक है. Now the difference is actually at the postganglionic fibers. ठीक है, ganglion तो पता होता है ना, just revising it. ये nerve निकलती है spinal cord से, this is the ganglion जहाँ पे दो nerves meet करेगी, then the next one starts from here, which will end on a neuromuscular junction. This is the usual pathway. This is your spinal cord. ठीक है, and this is your neuromuscular junction. So एक basic funda, I hope most of you would be confused. तो physio का एक point clear हो जाएगा, if you allow me, तो I can tell you. सबसे पहले न्यूरॉन्स हैज टू पार्ट्स. क्या दो पार्ट होते हैं न्यूरॉन के? एक्सॉन एंड सेल बॉडी. एक्सॉन एंड सेल बॉडी. सो कलेक्शन ऑफ एक्सॉन इनसाइड द सीएनएस इज नोन एज, कलेक्शन ऑफ एक्सॉन्स इनसाइड द सीएनएस इज नोन एज, इधर बताता हूं, याद रख लो, एक्सॉन्स और सेल बॉडीज. ये इंपॉर्टेंट है इसलिए बता रहा हूं, अदरवाइज आई वुड हैव स्किप्ड इट. ओके, द कलेक्शन, एक बेसिक फंडा समझ में आ जाएगा, बाकी कुछ नहीं. Collection of axons within the CNS would be known as tracts. Collection of axons within the CNS are known as tracts. Collection of axons within the CNS are known as tracts. Whereas collection of axons outside the CNS are known as nerves. Collection of axons outside the CNS are known as axons. So they either form a tract or they either form a nerve. ठीक है, याद रखना. Collection of axons inside CNS. Collection of axons inside CNS. Collection of axons outside CNS. Collection of axons outside CNS. Then cell body जो होती है तुम्हारी soma. Okay. So collection of cell bodies within CNS would be known as a nucleus. Within a CNS it would be known as a, and collection of cell bodies outside the nucleus is known as the ganglion. Shabash. ठीक है, अब फंडा क्लियर हो गया, अब दिक्कत नहीं है कुछ। ये मुझे भी कंफ्यूजन था जब मैं पढ़ता था, तो इसीलिए ये बता दिया। आई नो दिस इज अ कॉमन क्वेरी। ठीक है, जल्दी से, कलेक्शन ऑफ सेल बॉडीज इनसाइड सीएनएस, कलेक्शन ऑफ सेल बॉडीज इनसाइड न्यूक्लियर इनसाइड सीएनएस, कलेक्शन ऑफ सेल बॉडीज इनसाइड सीएनएस एंड आउटसाइड सीएनएस, आउटसाइड सीएनएस कलेक्शन ऑफ सेल बॉडीज। कोई फंडा एक कोई इशू नहीं है इधर। ठीक है, अभी गैंग्लियन समझ में आ गया क्या है ये गैंग्लियन। ठीक है, this is your ganglion, so these would be your preganglionic and these would be your postganglionic fibers. So abhi baat chal rahi thi, all preganglionic fibers of autonomic nervous system will secrete acetylcholine, whereas the postganglionic fibers of parasympathetic nervous system will secrete acetylcholine. Postganglionic fibers of parasympathetic nervous system will secrete, postganglionic fibers of parasympathetic nervous system will secrete acetylcholine. But the postganglionic fibers of sympathetic or adrenergic nervous system will secrete noradrenaline or adrenaline. ठीक है, ये समझ गए? So postganglionic fibers of sympathetic nervous system, postganglionic fibers of sympathetic nervous system, postganglionic fibers of sympathetic nervous system, postganglionic fibers of parasympathetic, postganglionic fibers of parasympathetic, preganglionic fibers. Whether sympathetic or parasympathetic, all of them acetylcholine. अब क्या होता है? Sympathetic nervous system involves many of the organs. One of the organ is sweat glands. One of the important organ is sweat glands. Okay. So कोई दिक्कत नहीं है, पढ़ लो, ठीक है? चलो. So please remember, what did we say? Postganglionic fibers of the sympathetic system will secrete. Postganglionic fibers of sympathetic system will secrete noradrenaline, except for sweat glands. Okay, because the postganglionic fibers of sweat glands, though it is a part of sympathetic, they secrete. And this was a question which was asked. ठीक है? याद रख लेना. Postganglionic fibers of adrenergic. Postganglionic fibers of adrenergic. Postganglionic fibers of adrenergic. Postganglionic fibers of adrenergic. Postganglionic fibers of sweat glands. Postganglionic fibers of sweat glands are acetylcholine. No issues with this. I hope this is clear with you. Now, important question aur ek hai, biochem se bhi aa sakta hai, pharma se bhi aa sakta hai, aur physio se bhi. Rate limiting step of acetylcholine synthesis is uptake of choline. Rate limiting step of acetylcholine synthesis is uptake of choline from the synapse. ठीक है, याद रख लेना. Any issues with this slide? Shall I repeat it once again? और ठीक है सब. End में repeat कर लेंगे एक बार. ठीक है, moving further now. Talking about some parasympathomimetic drugs. Those drugs which will mimic the action of the parasympathetic or the cholinergic system, उसके जैसे काम करें, ठीक है? So the first drug that is important is pilocarpine. Pilocarpine is from which group? वो तो मुझे पता है, लिखा हुआ है. उसके पहले रिसेप्टर समझ लो. आई होप दैट रिसेप्टर एक बार क्लियर हो जाए तो आगे. मैंने रिसेप्टर डिटेल में नहीं जाऊंगा, बस आई टेल यू द रिसेप्टर्स एंड लोकेशन. ठीक, या सो रिसेप्टर्स कोलिनर्जिक सिस्टम में कौन से दो टाइप के रिसेप्टर्स होते हैं? मस्किरिनिक एंड निकोटिनिक. कोलिनर्जिक में कौन से दो टाइप? मस्किरिनिक एंड निकोटिनिक. ठीक है, आगे देखते एक बार फिर इजी मैं लिख देता हूं यहां पे तो आसान हो जाएगा. ठीक है, पैरासिंपैथेटिक नर्वस सिस्टम हैज टू टाइप्स ऑफ रिसेप्टर्स. दोज आर मस्किरिनिक एंड निकोटिनिक. मस्किरिनिक एंड आर अ पार्ट ऑफ पैरासिंपैथेटिक नर्वस सिस्टम. ठीक है, मस्किरिनिक यूजुअली मस्किरिनिक रिसेप्टर्स आर ऑफ फाइव टाइप्स. ठीक है, आउट ऑफ देम थ्री ऑफ देम आर इंपॉर्टेंट, M1, M2 एंड M3. कैन एनीबडी टेल मी? M1 रिसेप्टर्स आर लोकेटेड इन M1 रिसेप्टर से M1 रिसेप्टर से M2 रिसेप्टर से M2 रिसेप्टर से M2 रिसेप्टर से एंड M3 रिसेप्टर्स ऑल अदर प्लेसेस लाइक your glands, pupils, bronchus, ठीक है, GIT, ब्लैडर सब जगह पे, ठीक है अभी इतना नहीं दिख रहा मैं, ठीक है तो याद रख लो M1N M1N M2N M2N M3N all other places M3N all other places, ठीक है. निकोटिनिक कितने टाइप के होते हैं? टू टाइप्स, NN and NM. NN are located in ganglia. NN ना मतलब नर्व में कोई इधर लोकेटेड है. So NN are located in NN are located in NMN NM नाम से पता चल रहा है न्यूरोमस्कुलर जंक्शन, ठीक है. These are the receptors of which system? Parasympathetic or cholinergic system. Then if we talk about the receptors of sympathetic nervous system, also known as adrenergic nervous system, then we have how many types? Again two types, that is alpha and alpha and alpha and beta and so out of those alpha ke do type hote hain, alpha 1 and alpha 1 receptors are located on blood vessels and pupils pe hote hain, theek hai. More commonly smooth muscles pe bol sakte ho tum, okay. So alpha 1 receptors are located on smooth muscles, mainly blood vessels. Alpha 1 receptors are located on smooth muscles. Alpha 2 receptors are located on they are located in the synapse, but on the presynaptic terminal or the presynaptic neuron. Alpha 2 receptors are located on the alpha 2 receptors are located on the presynaptic neuron. Important baat kya hai alpha 2 ki? ये sympathetic nervous system का विभिषण है. I hope all of you are quite aware of Ramayana. So घर का यही रंग का ढाई जो बोलते हैं ना, ये खुद की लगवा लेता है अपने सिस्टम की, ठीक है. खुद ही खुद के सिस्टम के लगवाता है. So this acts as brakes on sympathetic nervous system. Alpha 2 receptor acts as brakes on sympathetic nervous system. मतलब जिसने खाना दिया उसी की थाली में छेद कर दिया, ठीक है. So alpha 2 receptor acts as brakes on sympathetic nervous system. कोई नहीं बोलेगा. Alpha 2 are located on presynaptic neuron. Alpha 2 are located on and alpha 1 are located on alpha 1 are located on sharp. Then beta are of three types majorly. Beta 1, beta 2 and beta 3 receptors. Beta 1 are located in heart. Kitna heart hota human ko? 8. Therefore beta 1 hai. Beta 1 hai. Kitne lungs hote hai? 2. Therefore beta 2 hai. Therefore beta 2 hai. And beta 3 hai. Bladder, adipose tissue, हर जगह पे बाकी, okay? All others, three वाले all others ही होते हैं, ठीक है? So जल्दी से एक बार revise कर लेंगे. Cholinergic system has how many type of receptors? Two, muscarinic and nicotinic and muscarinic. M1 is located in M1N, M2N, M2N, M3N, M3N, nicotinic. NN NNN NMN NMN then sympathetic nervous system, also known as adrenergic nervous system, has two types of receptors, alpha and beta and alpha. Alpha ke do types, alpha 1 on alpha 1 on alpha 2 on alpha 2 on. It acts as to which system? Sympathetic nervous system. ठीक है, next beta. Beta 1 on? Beta 1 on? Beta 2 on? Beta 2 on? Beta 3 in? ठीक है, शाबाश. अब ये समझ गया हो ना तो इजी जाएगा समझना, ठीक है. Now pilocarpin कौन से रिसेप्टर को ब्लॉक करता है? जल्दी से, pilocarpin is important drug. इसीलिए मैं individual drugs बस वही लूंगा जिन पे individual questions बन सकते हैं, ठीक है. Muscarinic receptor blocker M3, शाबाश. So pilocarpin is a M3 blocker. Pilocarpin is a P for pilocarpin, P for pupils. It will act on P for pilocarpin, P for so pilocarpin acts on and parasympathetic की बात चल रही है तो ढंग से सोच के बताना. Pilocarpin will lead to what? Parasympathetic की बात चल रही है. Pilocarpin on pupil will cause it will cause constriction of the pupil, that is meiosis. Resting stage में क्या करोगे? सोओगे ना? For सोने के लिए क्या होना चाहिए? Constriction of pupil, that is meiosis. So pilocarpin causes it acts on M3 receptor. It is a M3 blocker. Now tell me, pilocarpine is used as a drug of choice in which condition? Which type of glaucoma? एक भी क्या बोले क्लोज एंगल याद रख लो पाइलोकार्पिन इज द ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस फॉर अक्यूट अटैक्स ऑफ एंगल क्लोजर ग्लाउकोमा याद रख लो पाइलोकार्पिन इज द ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस फॉर अक्यूट एंगल क्लोजर ग्लाउकोमा पाइलोकार्पिन इज द ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस फॉर अक्यूट एंगल क्लोजर ग्लाउकोमा पाइलोकार्पिन का काम क्या होता है इट कॉजेस मियोसिस देयरफॉर इट विल ब्रेक द अटैक ठीक है इट विल ब्रेक द एपिसोड ठीक है therefore the drug of choice for acute angle closure glaucoma would be the drug of choice for acute angle closure glaucoma is pilocarpine is the drug of choice for acute angle closure glaucoma याद रख लेना ठीक है then angle closure glaucoma वैसे बहुत सारे और drugs भी use होते हैं अभी यहाँ पे ही बता दो बहुत बोल रहे थे open angle so now tell me which is the drug of choice for open angle glaucoma then Many drugs have been used. Okay, which is the drug of choice for open-angle glaucoma? Manitol is the first drug to be given. मैंने मैंने लिखाया होगा ये properly. Manitol is the first drug to be given. It is not the drug of choice. मैम ने ये लिखाया होगा. Manitol is the first drug to be given in open-angle glaucoma. It is not the drug of choice. Latanoprost. That is prostaglandin analog. याद रख लेना. Which is the drug of choice for open-angle glaucoma? Latanoprost, which is a prostaglandin analog. Important question है glaucoma के वो कर रहे हैं यहाँ पे. Drug of choice for open angle glaucoma? Latanoprost. Drug of choice for open angle glaucoma? Drug of choice for open angle glaucoma? Which is a prostaglandin analog. Drug of choice for angle closure glaucoma? Pilocarpine. Drug of choice for acute angle closure glaucoma? Pilocarpine. ठीक है. चलो. Next one, talking about the next group of drugs that is acetylcholine esterase inhibitors. So now we have an enzyme in the synapse which is known as acetylcholine esterase, right? So this acetylcholine esterase enzyme will break down acetylcholine. Acetylcholine esterase ka kaam kya hoga? To break down acetylcholine. ACE jisme bhi aata hai, yaad rakh lena. ACE jisme bhi aata hai, those are enzymes. Theek hai? So acetylcholine esterase enzyme will break down acetylcholine. So now, which are the group of drugs? So which are acetylcholine esterase inhibitors? We have two types, reversible inhibitors and irreversible inhibitors. Reversible inhibitors would be drugs like physostigmin or shabash, neostigmin or pyridostigmin or अरे बार बार एक ही नाम बताओगे क्या? दोनों पेजल कैन बी देयर और एड्रोफोनियम सो रिवर्सिबल एसिटाइलकोलीन एस्टरेज इनहिबिटर्स आर फोर ड्रग्स फर्स्ट इज सेकंड इज थर्ड इज पाइरिडोस्टिग्मिन एंड फोर्थ इज एड्रोफोनियम फोर्थ इज क्यों लिखवाया क्योंकि चारों ड्रग से वनलाइनर्स बनते हैं इसलिए लिखवाया ठीक है नहीं तो नहीं लिखवाता नाउ इररिवर्सिबल एसिटाइलकोलीन एस्टरेज इनहिबिटर्स आर ऑर्गेनोफॉस्फेट्स एंड कार्बामेट्स इररिवर्सिबल एसिटाइलकोलीन एस्टरेज इनहिबिटर्स आर ऑर्गेनोफॉस्फेट्स एंड कार्बामेट्स इररिवर्सिबल एसिटाइलकोलीन एस्टरेज इनहिबिटर्स आर ऑर्गेनोफॉस्फेट्स एंड कार्बामेट्स एंड रिवर्सिबल एसिटाइलकोलीन एस्टरेज इनहिबिटर्स आर फर्स्ट इज पाइज़ोस्टिग्मिन सेकंड इज neostigmin third is pyridostigmin and fourth is heterophonium theek hai samajh gaye ab one liners karte hain drugs ke group samajhna isliye important hai because mechanism of action pucha ja sakta hai theek hai and this is the reason organophosphate and carbamate poisoning mein as acetylcholine esterase is irreversibly inhibited therefore acetylcholine ki level niche jayegi kya nahi because the enzyme which breaks down acetylcholine has been inhibited Therefore, acetylcholine will keep on increasing in the synapse. And excess of acetylcholine will lead to which symptoms? Parasympathetic or cholinergic symptoms like meiosis and increased secretion. So, आगे देखते हैं अभी इतना समझ लो ठीक है आगे बढ़ते हैं ना ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस करते हैं फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल ये बता दो अट्रोपिन बिलोंग्स टू विच ग्रुप ऑफ ड्रग muscarinic agonist या muscarinic antagonist शाबाश so please remember atropine is a muscarinic blocker or a muscarinic antagonist atropine is a muscarinic atropine is a muscarinic Atropine is a muscarinic. Therefore, for atropine poisoning, which drug should be given? We shall give parasympathetic mimetic or cholinergic drugs. Okay? Because atropine is an anticholinergic drug. Atropine kaisi drug hai? Anticholinergic. Therefore, poisoning mein kaun si drug deni hogi? Cholinergic drug. So therefore, the drug of choice for atropine poisoning is? Physostigmine. Drug of choice for atropine poisoning is? Drug of choice for atropine poisoning is? Drug of choice for atropine poisoning is? Atropine belongs to which group of drugs? Muscarinic blocker. Atropine belongs to which group of drugs? Muscarinic blocker. Now, aage badhte hain. Drug of choice for cobra bite. Cobra bite usually leads to sympathetic symptoms, mydriasis vagara. So, to overcome those sympathetic symptoms, we should give parasympathetic drug like neostigmine. Drug of choice for cobra bite is? Drug of choice for cobra bite is? Drug of choice for cobra bite is? Now, neostigmine will act on muscarinic receptors also and nicotinic also. Cobra bite mein usually the defect is on the nicotinic receptors. Kyun faltu mein muscarinic ki bali chadha rahe ho? So, you will give atropine along with it. So, if this is there in the option, then the drug of choice would become neostigmine plus atropine. If this is there in the option, the drug of choice will become neostigmine plus atropine. Atropine is given to counteract the muscarinic side effects. Because neostigmine can act on both the receptors, so we don't want muscarinic effects. So, to counteract those muscarinic side effects, which drug is given? Which drug is given? Which drug is given? Along with? अगर सिंगल ड्रग पता नहीं ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस क्या होगी सिंगल ड्रग इज कॉम्बिनेशन इज नियोस्टिग्मिन प्लस शाबाश नेक्स्ट वन इज मायस्थीनिया ग्रेविस मिडल एज फीमेल प्रेजेंटिंग टू यू विद बायलैटरल टॉसिस विद वीकनेस प्रोग्रेसिंग थ्रू आउट द डे क्लासिकल केस ऑफ मायस्थीनिया ग्रेविस व्हाट इज द ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस ऑफ मायस्थीनिया ग्रेविस Pyridostigmine. Yaad rakhna, the drug of choice for myasthenia gravis is? Drug of choice for myasthenia gravis is? We can also use neostigmine, but pyridostigmine is used, that is a longer acting drug. Theek hai, yaad rakhna. So, drug of choice poochha, maine treatment ke liye baat chal rahi hai. Theek hai, tum kya aa rahe ho, mujhe pata hai, I'll discuss it further. Theek hai, drug of choice for myasthenia gravis? Drug of choice for myasthenia gravis? Drug of choice for myasthenia gravis? Drug of choice for cobra bite? Drug of choice for cobra bite? And drug of choice for atropine poisoning? Drug of choice for atropine poisoning? Up in myasthenia gravis also, the defect is at the neuromuscular junction, again at the nicotinic receptors. Kyu muscarinic ki bali chadhani hai? Therefore, atropine is also recommended along with pyridostigmine in cases of myasthenia gravis. Theek hai? याद रख लेना ठीक है द मोस्ट स्पेसिफिक ट्रीटमेंट वुड बी दिस वन वी नीड टू काउंटरैक्ट दोस मस्किरिनिक साइड इफेक्ट्स ऑफ पाइरिडोस्टिग्मिन आल्सो ठीक है देन मूविंग फर्दर ये बाद में फिर से रिवाइज कर लेंगे इंपॉर्टेंट है तीन नेक्स्ट वन टेंसिलोन टेस्ट इज यूज्ड फॉर मायस्थीनिया ग्रेविस टेंसिलोन टेस्ट में विच ड्रग इज यूज शाबाश एड्रोफोनियम इज यूज बिकॉज इट इज अ Short acting drug. Very good. Adrafonium is used because it is a short acting drug. And tensilon test mein which drug is used? Adrafonium because it is short acting. And tensilon test is used to differentiate myasthenia gravis from cholinergic crisis. Tensilon test is used to differentiate myasthenia gravis from cholinergic crisis. Tensilon test is used to differentiate myasthenia gravis from After androphonium, symptoms worsen. This is a case of cholinergic crisis. And after androphonium, the symptoms improve. This is a case of symptoms improve in? Symptoms improve in? And symptoms worsen in? Symptoms worsen in? Any issues with this? Moving further. ठीक है? याद रखना, diagnosis के लिए अगर पूछा जाए, then it is which drug? Androphonium. ट्रीटमेंट के लिए पूछा जाए देन इट इज विच ड्रग पाइरिडोस्टिग्मिन नो इश्यूज विद दिस मूविंग फर्दर टॉकिंग अबाउट ओपीसी पॉइजनिंग ओपीसी पॉइजनिंग रिजेंबल्स विच सिस्टम कोलिनर्जिक या एड्रेनर्जिक कोलिनर्जिक क्या बात हुई थी ओपीसीज आर इररिवर्सिबल एसिटाइल कोलीन एस्टरेज इनहिबिटर्स ओके देयरफॉर दे विल इंक्रीज द लेवल ऑफ एसिटाइल कोलीन landing of the patient in cholinergic crisis like condition. Excess of cholinergic symptoms would be there, right? So cholinergic symptoms would be there like constriction of pupil known as
meiosis.
और बहुत ज्यादा छोटे हो जाते हैं मतलब pin point pupils. A farmer has taken some drug and presented to you in emergency with pin point pupils along with increased secretion. Okay, increased secretion मतलब excessive salivation, excessive urination, diarrhea, all of that. Okay, excessive lacrimation, everything would be there. ठीक है, so this is a classical case. OPC is the most important topic मेरे हिसाब से. ठीक है, इतनी बार repeat हो चुका है ना, so याद रखना. Usually OPC poisoning case will be a farmer presenting to you with two important symptoms. First is pinpoint pupils and second is increased secretion. ठीक है, OPCs are organophosphates and carbamates. याद रखो, like malathion. ठीक है, malathion, parathion like drugs, carboxyl. Then, which is the drug of choice for OPC poisoning? The drug of choice for OPC poisoning is? Drug of choice for OPC poisoning is? Drug of choice for OPC poisoning is? Atropine is a life-saving drug in cases of? Puri OPC poisoning. Carbamates mein bhi diya jata. Theek hai, yaad rakho. Theek hai, important hai, yaad rakh lena. Now, atropine is given immediately to a patient who is presenting to you with OPC poisoning. So, atropine should be given repetitively until and unless we can see improvement in the symptoms. ठीक है, and improvement in symptoms is known as atropinization. ठीक है, मतलब atropine का effect दिखने लगा, that is atropinization. ठीक है, so atropine should be given until atropinization. So how to recognize that atropinization has occurred, which is the most common symptom? Most common क्या देखोगे? Dilation of pupils, that is. So most common symptom is? Most common symptom of atropinization is? Most common symptom of atropinization is? Most common symptom of atropinization is? Most reliable symptom of atropinization is? Sorry, not symptom, sign say. ठीक है. So most reliable sign or most specific sign for atropinization would be decreased secretions. Okay. और वो यूजुअली देखा जाता है विद द ओरल म्यूकोसा व्हिच वुड बी ड्राई नाउ. ठीक है, याद रख लेना. बट डिक्रीज सिक्रीशन इज, दो इट इज मोर स्पेसिफिक, इट इज नॉट कॉमनली यूज्ड. कॉमनली यूज्ड वन इज मिडरियासिस, कॉमन वन इज, मोस्ट स्पेसिफिक वन इज. ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस फॉर ओपीसी पॉइजनिंग, एट्रोपिन इज गिवन अंटिल. मोस्ट कॉमन साइन फॉर एट्रोपिनाइजेशन. मोस्ट रिलायबल और स्पेसिफिक साइन फॉर एट्रोपिनाइजेशन. Any issues with this? No. Atropine is a life-saving drug. Important है ये. ठीक है, याद रख लेना. Next one. अगर the question is now not the drug of choice or not the life-saving drug, they have asked you which is the most specific drug for OPC poisoning. What would be your answer? Oxime. That is pralidoxime. Which is the most specific drug? Which is the most specific drug? Pralidoxime, also written as PAM. ठीक है. Most specific drug for OPC poisoning is? Most specific drug for OPC poisoning is? Specific क्यों है बता रहा हूँ. Because mechanism of action क्या है? It is a acetylcholine esterase reactivator. So main mechanism, main problem क्या थी? Acetylcholine esterase inhibition हो गया था. So we need to reactivate the acetylcholine esterase enzyme, and that is done by which drug? Pralidoxime. Therefore pralidoxime is the most स्पेसिफिक ड्रग यूज इन विच पॉइजनिंग. जल्दी से, ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस, ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस, मोस्ट स्पेसिफिक ड्रग, मोस्ट स्पेसिफिक ड्रग. एनी इश्यूज विद दिस? नो इश्यूज. ठीक है, दो अलग अलग क्वेश्चन से अलग अलग आंसर होंगे. मूविंग फर्दर नाउ, ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस फॉर मशरूम पॉइजनिंग नाउ. ठीक है, मशरूम पॉइजनिंग कैन आइदर बी अर्ली मशरूम पॉइजनिंग और लेट मशरूम. मशरूम आर नॉट नाउअडेज कॉमन. दो से तीन साल पहले मशरूम पॉइजनिंग में बहुत क्वेश्चन आते थे एग्जाम्स. ठीक है, सो ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस फॉर अर्ली मशरूम पॉइजनिंग, अर्ली मशरूम पॉइजनिंग वुड बी कॉज बाय क्लीटोसाइव वगैरह स्पीशीज. ओके, इट इज कॉज बाय क्लीटोसाइव आइनोसाइव स्पीशीज, नॉट इम्पॉर्टेंट. ठीक है, इट वुड क्लीटोसाइव, इट वुड मोस्टली रिजेंबल अट्रोपिन पॉइजनिंग. अर्ली मशरूम पॉइजनिंग रिजेंबल्स, अर्ली मशरूम पॉइजनिंग रिजेंबल्स, सॉरी, अर्ली मशरूम पॉइजनिंग रिजेंबल्स ओपीसी पॉइजनिंग. अर्ली मशरूम पॉइजनिंग रिजेंबल्स, अर्ली मशरूम पॉइजनिंग रिजेंबल्स, अर्ली मशरूम पॉइजनिंग रिजेंबल्स therefore the drug of choice would be drug of choice for early mushroom poisoning drug of choice for early mushroom poisoning drug of choice for late mushroom poisoning it is mainly caused by amanita group of mushrooms okay and it resembles atropine poisoning and it resembles atropine poisoning so atropine shall be given in this condition no so please remember atropine is absolutely contraindicated yaad rakhna atropine is the drug of choice for early mushroom poisoning atropine is the drug of choice for early mushroom poisoning but atropine is absolutely contraindicated in late mushroom poisoning atropine is absolutely contraindicated in late mushroom poisoning so for late mushroom poisoning we can give drugs like fizoxigmine wagera but usually symptomatic management would be the best answer theek hai usually symptomatic management kari jati hai theek hai moving further now drug of choice for datura poisoning datura is a what datura is a delirium datura kya hai delirium which causes delirium clouding of consciousness karta hai na datura important hai datura bahut zyada from fmt pharma dono point of view se ठीक है धतुरा के क्वेश्चंस हर बार आए हैं एग्जाम्स इधर ओपीसी और धतुरा या दोनों के दोनों आता है एग्जाम्स ठीक है याद रखना सो धतुरा इज अ डेलिरियम इट रिजेंबल्स विच ड्रग शाबाश धतुरा रिजेंबल्स अट्रोपीन सो धतुरा पॉइजनिंग वुड बी मोर लाइक अट्रोपीन पॉइजनिंग धतुरा पॉइजनिंग वुड बी मोर लाइक देयरफॉर द ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस फॉर धतुरा पॉइजनिंग वुड आल्सो बी शाबाश So, ऐसा अगर समझ गए हो तो कितना इजी हो जाता है फालतू में रटते रहते नहीं ठीक है सो ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस फॉर एट्रोपिन पॉइजनिंग ऑल्सो इजी अभी कोई दिक्कत नहीं एट डीज धतुरा की याद रखना क्वेश्चन में एट डीज के सिम्टम्स आएंगे ठीक है वही आता है मूविंग फर्दर नाउ पैरासिम्पेथोलाइटिक ड्रग्स मतलब दोज ड्रग्स विल काउंटर व्हिच विल काउंटरैक्ट द कोलिनर्जिक सिस्टम दीज आर नोन एज एंटी कोलिनर्जिक ड्रग्स ओके पैरासिम्पेथोलाइटिक्स आर आल्सो नोन एज एंटी कोलिनर्जिक ड्रग्स ठीक है एंड द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट एंटी कोलिनर्जिक ड्रग इज अट्रोपिन मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट एंटी कोलिनर्जिक ड्रग इज अट्रोपिन अट्रोपिन वॉज अ मस्किरिनेट Atropine was a muscarinic antagonist or a muscarinic blocker. याद रख लेना, ठीक है? Important है. Atropine has either no or very minimal effects on nicotinic receptors. ये याद रखना, okay? So atropine is a muscarinic blocker. Atropine is a muscarinic. Now atropine is used as a drug of choice. ये mnemonic है. ABC OPC. Atropine is a drug of choice. Atropine is a drug of choice. Atropine is a drug of choice. So now first A goes for B goes for bradycardia. C goes for cycloplegia in children c goes for in children so kya kya yaad rakhoge atropine is a drug of choice for abc opc a for yaad rakh lo b for and c for cycloplegia kya hota hai paralysis of ciliary muscles is known as cycloplegia so whenever the ciliary muscles would be paralyzed or relaxed that would lead to dilatation of the pupil that is mydriasis and this is done before examination of the eye jab hame fundus dekhna hai for that purpose we do dilatation of the pupil prior okay and for that purpose usually in children which is the drug of choice are which is the drug of choice for cycloplegia in children Drug of choice for cyclopegia in children. Drug of choice for cyclopegia in children. Drug of choice for cyclopegia in children. And if my question changes, the drug of choice for cyclopegia in adults. Chabasha. Drug of choice for cyclopegia in adults is tropicamide. Can anybody tell me the reason? सही है, ऑप्टा अच्छे से पढ़ा है शायद. चलो, so because atropine is a longer acting drug, it has its cyclopegic action for more than 3 weeks, that is more than 21 days. Okay, therefore there would be blurring of vision in adults. ठीक है, काम नहीं कर पाओगे. Therefore the drug of choice for cyclopegia in children would be atropine, whereas the drug of choice for cyclopegia in adults is because it is a shorter acting drug. Because it is a shorter acting drug, important है. और also atropine is the drug of choice in which poisoning? कोई दिक्कत इसमें नहीं है. जल्दी से atropine. Atropine is a muscarinic blocker. It is drug of choice in which condition? ABC, OPC. A for? A for? A for? B for? B for? C for? C for? And O for? OPC for? OPC poisoning. Drug of choice for cyclopegia in adults is? Drug of choice for cyclopegia in adults is? Any issues with this? No. Moving further. Now, kuch important drug of choice aur hai, jo dekhenge. Theek hai? Sabse pehle, if I ask you, what is the drug of choice for drug-induced Parkinsonism? Shabash. So, usually, drug of choice for drug-induced Parkinsonism is an anticholinergic drug like benzhexol, also known as triphenidyl. It is also known as यही था ना मेडिसिन के टेस्ट में. ठीक है, ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस फॉर ड्रग इंड्यूस्ड पार्किंसनिज्म इज बेंजहेक्सोल और ट्राइहेक्सीफेनिडिल. ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस फॉर ड्रग इंड्यूस्ड पार्किंसनिज्म इज बेंजहेक्सोल और ट्राइहेक्सीफेनिडिल. ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस फॉर ड्रग इंड्यूस्ड पार्किंसनिज्म इज बेंजहेक्सोल और ट्राइहेक्सीफेनिडिल, व्हिच इज अ एंटीकोलिनर्जिक ड्रग, व्हिच इज अ. Now, if I ask you, which are the drugs which lead to drug-induced Parkinsonism? So, those are typical antipsychotics. Which are the drugs which cause drug-induced Parkinsonism? Which are the drugs which cause drug-induced Parkinsonism? So, yaad rakhna, drug-induced Parkinsonism is caused by typical antipsychotics. Drug-induced Parkinsonism is caused by typical antipsychotics, and the drug of choice for drug induced Parkinsonism is benzhexol or triphenidyl, which is an anticholinergic agent. ठीक है, ये समझ गए. Moving further, which is the drug of choice for motion sickness? Hyoscine, also known as scopolamine. ठीक है, which is the drug of choice for motion sickness? Which is the drug of एक बोलो, पहला ही बोलो, hyoscine बोलो. But bolo, which is the drug of choice for motion sickness?
Hyoscine.
Drug of choice for motion sickness?
Hyoscine.
Drug of choice for mountain sickness? Drug of choice for mountain sickness is? Acetazolamide. Drug of choice for mountain sickness is? So usually motion sickness kya hota hai? Whenever a person sits in a vehicle, the chemoreceptor trigger zone is stimulated and that leads to vomiting. That is motion sickness, for which the drug of choice is? Hyoscine, also known as scopolamine. And the drug of choice for mountain sickness would be acetazolamide. Usually at higher altitudes there is hypoxia. Okay, that is overcome by the acetazolamide drug. Which is from which group? Hyoscine is an anticholinergic agent. इसीलिए यहाँ discuss कर दिया. Hyoscine is an anticholinergic agent. Therefore discussed over here. Anti देख देता हूँ. गड़बड़ कर दूँगा. ठीक है. Acetazolamide is from which group? Shabash. It is from carbonate anhydrase inhibitor. Acetazolamide is a? Acetazolamide is a? Acetazolamide is a? Then, drug of choice for morning sickness? What is morning sickness? Morning sickness is excessive vomiting during pregnancy. Morning sickness is excessive vomiting during? So, it is known as hyperemesis gravidarum. Hyperemesis मतलब excessive vomiting, gravidarum means pregnancy. So excessive vomiting during pregnancy or hyperemesis gravidarum, also known as morning sickness. Drug of choice क्या होगी? Drug of choice for morning sickness? Drug of choice for morning sickness? Drug of choice for morning sickness? Which is a H1 blocker. Which is a H1 blocker. ठीक है, ग्रुप भले ही ना याद रखो, ड्रग का नाम याद रखना इंपॉर्टेंट. ठीक है, चलो जल्दी से ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस ना. ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस फॉर ड्रग इंड्यूस्ड पार्किंसनिज्म और ट्राइमेक्सिफेनिक. ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस फॉर मोशन सिकनेस आल्सो नोन एज स्कोपोलामाइन. ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस फॉर माउंटेन सिकनेस. ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस फॉर माउंटेन सिकनेस. ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस फॉर मॉर्निंग सिकनेस. ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस फॉर हाइपरिमेसिस ग्रेविडाया. शाबाश. Moving further, now talking about sympathomimetic drugs, the drug which will mimic the action of sympathetic or adrenergic system. So these are also known as adrenergic drugs. ठीक है? So the most important drug अभी देखते हैं. The drug of choice for shock plus oliguria would be? Shabash, it is dopamine. Drug of choice for shock plus oliguria is?
Dopamine.
Drug of choice for shock plus oliguria is?
Dopamine.
Dopamine. याद रख लेना, shock is a condition when the cardiac output is decreased. Cardiac output क्या हो जाता है? कम. Okay, that is what is shock. Oliguria means urine output less than 400 ml per day. Oliguria means urine output less than. Oliguria means urine output less than. Oliguria means urine output less than. And anuria means urine output less than 100 ml per day. Anuria is urine output less than 100 ml per day. Oliguria is urine output less than 400 ml per day. And normal urine output is 1.5 to 2 liters. Normal urine output is 1.5 to 2 liters. Oliguria less than? Anuria less than? कोई इशू नहीं है ना. And drug of choice for shock plus oliguria would be dopamine. याद रखना. Dopamine acts on three receptors. इस पे क्वेश्चन था, इसीलिए एक्स्ट्रा मैं बता रहा हूँ. Dopamine on at low concentration can act on D1 receptors. At moderate concentration can act on beta-1 receptors. And at high concentrations can act on alpha-1 receptors. Dopamine acts on three receptors. At low concentration on, at low concentration on, at moderate on, at moderate concentration on. And on high concentration on, at high concentrations on alpha 1 receptors. ठीक है, अगर जानना है तो more less than 2 microgram, 2 to 10 microgram and more than 10 microgram per kg per minute. ठीक है, ये just for remembering this. Drug of choice now about anaphylactic. Shock can be various types. ठीक है, shock का एक basic मतलब क्या होता है? Decrease cardiac output. Shock का basic मतलब क्या है? Decrease cardiac output. It is a state of hypoperfusion. Organs are not getting enough blood. That is shock. ठीक है? So there are various types. Out of which one of the most important type is anaphylactic shock. Now tell me, anaphylactic shock is which type of hypersensitivity? Shabash. Anaphylactic shock is type 1 hypersensitivity. Anaphylactic shock is type 1 hypersensitivity because it is allergic. ठीक है, याद रखना. Anaphylactic shock के लिए drug of choice बताओ. शाबाश. Drug of choice for anaphylactic shock is? Drug of choice for anaphylactic shock is? Given by which route? Intramuscular route. Given by which route? IM route. In which concentration? 1:1000. 1:1000. याद रखना. Then what is the drug of choice for cardiac arrest? Again adrenaline. Okay, drug of choice for cardiac arrest is also? Drug of choice for cardiac arrest is also? Given by which route now?
IV.
Drug given by intravenous route. At what concentration? 1:10,000. Now if you are giving directly into the circulation, the drug should be dilute. Therefore the concentration should be low, that is 1:10,000. Jaldi se. Drug of choice for anaphylactic shock? Drug of choice for cardiac arrest? Route of administration in anaphylactic shock? Route of administration in cardiac arrest? Concentration of adrenaline in anaphylactic shock? Concentration of adrenaline in cardiac arrest? More dilute in? Because given by? Moving further, now talking about alpha 1 agonist. ठीक है? If we talk about alpha 1 agonist now, कितने type alpha receptors थे? Alpha 1 and alpha 2, which was acting as brakes on their own? Alpha 2. ठीक है. सो अल्फा टू के बारे में इतना अल्फा टू के बारे में इंपॉर्टेंट है दैट वी विल सी. पहले अल्फा वन ऑगोनिस की बात करते हैं. ओके, अल्फा वन ऑगोनिस में ज्यादा क्वेश्चन नहीं आते हैं, वन लाइनर्स आ सकते हैं. सो फर्स्ट ड्रग इज फिनाइलेफ्रिन. फिनाइलेफ्रिन कॉजेस मिड्रियासिस, बट विच काइंड ऑफ मिड्रियासिस? याद रखना, दिस वॉज अ क्वेश्चन विच हैज बीन आस्क्ड. Which is the drug which will lead to midriasis without cycloplegia? Which is the drug which will lead to midriasis without cycloplegia? Drug leading to midriasis without cycloplegia? So it does not paralyze the ciliary muscles. It has no action on the ciliary muscles. ठीक है, याद रख लेना. So please remember, the drug which causes midriasis without cycloplegia is? Drug which causes midriasis without cycloplegia is? Phenylephrine causes midriasis without cycloplegia. Important question which has been asked in NEET PG. ठीक है, so अपने में कभी भी आ सकता है. Then midodrine is also alpha 1 agonist. Midodrine is a drug of choice for spinal anesthesia, induced bradycardia में दे सकते हैं, और एक important point, posterior hypotension. याद रख लेना, posterior या orthostatic hypotension. Posterior or orthostatic hypotension. When you change the position and the BP drops, this is known as posterior or orthostatic hypotension. Orthostatic or posterior hypotension, for which the preferred drug is midodrine, which is a alpha 1 agonist. Bhulna nahi hai, one liner hai, bas yaad kar lo yaar. Moving further now. Talking about xylometazoline. Xylometazoline or oxymetazoline, ये नाम कहीं पढ़ा होगा? कहाँ पे पढ़ा है? नेजल ड्रॉप्स पे पढ़ा है ना? और ट्रिविन पे क्या होता है? और ट्रिविन में xylometazoline होता है. So this is a nasal decongestant. क्या है ये? So याद रख लो, बस एक लाइन याद रखनी है बस तुम्हें. ENT से पूछा जा सकता है क्वेश्चन. Xylometazoline और oxymetazoline, those are nasal decongestants and belong to which group? Alpha 1 agonist. Moving further, alpha 2 agonists are drugs like clonidine and methyldopa. Alpha 2 agonists are क्यों क्लोनिडिन और मिथाइलोपा का नाम लिखा मैंने? Because they were the preferred drugs. Okay, they were the preferred drugs for hypertension in pregnancy. They were the preferred drugs for hypertension in pregnancy. Which are the preferred drugs for hypertension in pregnancy? Clonidine and methyldopa. Clonidine and methyldopa and which group? Alpha 2 agonist. They act as brakes. Right, so they will stop the sympathetic nervous system and will improve hypertension. ठीक है, and those are safer to be given in pregnancy. So which are the preferred drugs for hypertension in pregnancy? If I change my question, which is the drug of choice for hypertension? The drug of choice for hypertension in pregnancy would be labetalol. Drug of choice for hypertension in pregnancy would be labetalol. याद रखना, मैंने क्या बोला था? Preferred drugs. JNC 8, Joint National Committee 8, अभी भी यह बोलता है कि methyldopa should be preferred, but Harrison doesn't say that. Harrison says labetalol is the best one. ठीक है, याद रखना. Then talking about beta 2 agonist, okay? Sorry, beta 2 agonist कौन से होते हैं? They are shorter acting and longer acting. Short acting are salbutamol and terbutaline. Salbutamol and terbutaline and salbutamol. These are also known as SABA. Short acting beta 2 agonist. These are also known as SABA. Short acting beta 2 agonist. And the long acting ones are salmeterol and formoterol. Those are salmeterol and these are known as LABA. Longer acting beta 2 agonist. Okay, short acting, salbutamol, and longer acting, easy, bada sa naam hai uska, isliye wo longer acting ho gaya. Theek hai, both of these drugs would be used. SABA or LABA are used in cases of
asthma.
Those are used in cases of
asthma.
Very good. Okay. So ये देखेंगे asthma में बाकी चीजें discuss करेंगे. Next one important बताओ. One of the beta 2 agonist is known as ritodrine. One of the beta 2 agonist is
ritodrine.
Ritodrine is a tocolite. शाबाश. Ritodrine is a which is used in cases of preterm labor. शाबाश. When the labor has induced before 34 weeks, that is known as preterm labor. Labor induced before 34 weeks are preterm labor. For preterm labor, the drug of choice should be any of the tocolytics, and one of them is ritodrine. ठीक है, याद रख लो. So याद रख लेना, ये important है. Ritodrine is a tocolytic, smooth muscle relaxant. It will relax your uterus. ठीक है, and that are and ritodrine is used in cases of preterm labor. Okay, it is used in cases of preterm labor. Very good. Moving further, easy. समझ गए अब ये. Which is the drug which leads to midriasis without cyclopegia?
Phenylephrine.
Which belongs to alpha 1 agonist. Important है, ठीक है. अभी ANS करके wind up करते session, ठीक है? Wow, 1.5 hour का session बोला होगा ना? So we are talking about sympatholytics. ठीक है, sympatholytics means anti adrenergic drugs. Sympatholytics means anti adrenergic drugs which will act against the adrenergic or sympathetic system. ठीक है. So now यहाँ पे important drugs है कुछ. Let's discuss about the important drug of choice. Okay, drug of choice for cheese reaction. It is phentolamine. Drug of choice for cheese reaction is. Drug of choice for cheese reaction is. Drug of choice for cheese reaction is. Phentolamine. ठीक है, cheese reaction में usually क्या होता है? Cheese reaction occurs due to a substance known as tyramine. Tyramine causes sudden severe hypertension. Okay, therefore to counter it, we have a drug of choice for cheese reaction known as phentolamine. Drug of choice for cheese reaction is. Drug of choice for cheese reaction is. Drug of choice for cheese reaction is. Confuse ना कर दो तुम लोग, ठीक है? Next, drug of choice for clonidine withdrawal is phentolamine. Drug of choice for clonidine withdrawal is also clonidine was from which group? Shabash. Clonidine was from alpha 2 agonist. Clonidine was from alpha 2 agonist. So if clonidine is given for a longer time and suddenly stopped, then that can lead to clonidine withdrawal, that is rebound hypertension. That can lead to rebound hypertension. This phenomenon is known as clonidine withdrawal, for which the drug of choice is phentolamine. The drug of choice for benign prostatic hyperplasia. एक बात सबसे पहले याद रख लो, what happens in benign prostatic hyperplasia? Common in which age group? Elderly males में common होता है. The prostate gland is enlarged, it is hypertrophied. Therefore, what happens? Prostate gland के बीच में से क्या पास करता है? Urethra. When the prostate gland would be hypertrophied, it will compress the urethra. Therefore, urination would be stopped. ठीक है? There would be intermittent urination, ये होगा ही नहीं बिल्कुल. ठीक है, this is usually the problem in benign prostatic hyperplasia. Important thing, benign prostatic hyperplasia का problem क्या है? Urination का problem है. ठीक है, so to overcome this, we need to give smooth muscle relaxant. We need to give smooth muscle relaxant, so the urethra will dilate and the urine can pass easily. ठीक है, this is the primary aim of treatment in BPH. ठीक है, so अब ये बताओ, which are the drugs which can be given in BPH then? Alpha. मैंने क्या बोला था? अल्फा 1 रिसेप्टर्स प्रेजेंट वेयर? स्मूथ मसल पे. सो स्मूथ मसल रिलैक्सेशन के लिए क्या करना पड़ेगा? अल्फा 1 अगोनिस्ट या अल्फा 1 एंटागोनिस्ट? एंटागोनिस्ट. सो अल्फा 1 ब्लॉकर्स और अल्फा 1 एंटागोनिस्ट आर प्रेफर्ड इन केसेस ऑफ बेनाइन प्रोस्टेटिक हाइपरप्लेजिया. ठीक है, बराबर. नाउ अल्फा 1 रिसेप्टर्स आर आल्सो ऑफ टू टाइप्स, अल्फा 1A एंड अल्फा 1B. सो will you prefer non-selective alpha blockers or selective alpha blockers? Selective alpha blockers which only and only will act on the urethra. Agar wo blood vessels pe kaam karenge, they will cause vasodilation that can land up the patient in hypotension. Right? So, isiliye, if the question comes, the drug of choice for benign prostatic hyperplasia should be alpha 1A blocker. Selective alpha 1A blocker. Alpha? Alpha? Drugs like tamsulosin or silodosin. Question has been asked. ठीक है, question important है बहुत ज़्यादा. Drug of choice for BPH is. Drug of choice for BPH is. Well of choice for BPH is? Belongs to which group?
Alpha
1A blocker. If I say, now the patient who has BPH, benign prostatic hyperplasia, is also suffering from hypertension. Now the drug of choice would be either prazosin or terazosin. Drugs like prazosin or terazosin, because these are non-selective alpha blockers. Usually alpha 1 blockers. These are
non-selective
alpha 1 blockers. These are
non-selective.
So they will also act on the urethra and they will also act on the blood vessels. Dilate kar dengi, hypertension karegi, toh bhi koi dikkat nahi because the person is already hypertensive. So drug of choice for BPH is Drug of choice for BPH plus hypertension is
Prazosin.
Prazosin is a non-selective alpha 1 blocker and tamsulosin is a alpha selective alpha 1A blocker. I know a question. BPH के लिए usually लिखवाता है कि drug of choice जो है that is finasteride. बहुत बार लिखवाया होगा कि drug of choice for BPH is finasteride. So please remember guys, the main aim of treatment अगर पूछा जाता है then it is urination. तुम्हें prostate की size अभी कम करनी नहीं और वो immediately होगी भी नहीं. So the main aim is to give your patient the primary relief for urination. So the drug of choice would be tamsulosin. BPH में finasteride is given for decreasing the size of prostate. Finasteride is given for decreasing the size of a question from surgery. Important hai, yaad rakho. Haan, bolo. Phentolamine is also used in cases of pheochromocytoma. Phentolamine is also used in cases of pheochromocytoma because in pheochromocytoma there is hypertension. To overcome that hypertension. Kaisa hypertension hota hai pheochromocytoma mein? Continuous episodic. Episodic. Only and only when catecholamine synthesis will increase, hypertension will arise. Easy one. Trial baad mein discuss karenge medicine mein. Now talking about the next one, which now talking about beta blockers. Ye kaun se the? Alpha blockers the. Abhi beta blockers ki agar hum baat kare, they see beta blockers are of three generations. First generation, second generation, third generation. First generation pehle pehle aaye the, those were non-selective. Sab pe kaam karte the. Second generation were selective on beta 1 receptors. Beta 1 kahan hota hai? Heart mein. So these were known as cardio selective. And third generation are alpha plus beta blockers. Third generation beta blockers also have action on alpha receptors. Alpha plus beta blockers. No issues. Agar nahi yaad rehta, ye important hai, ye yaad rakh lo abhi. Water soluble beta blockers are remembered by the mnemonic. Water soluble beta blockers. Water soluble beta blockers. A for atenolol. A for N for nadolol. N for N for S for sotalol. S for so which are water soluble beta blockers? A N S. A for A for N for N for S for S for important thing. Now nadolol is the longest acting beta blocker. Nada sabse lamba hota hai, so nadolol is the longest acting beta blocker. Now tell me which is the shortest acting beta blocker? Esmolol. Yaad rakhlo. Shortest acting beta blocker is esmolol. Longest acting is? Longest acting is? Shortest acting is? Shortest acting is? Water soluble are? A for? N for? S for? And therefore, as these are water soluble beta blockers, these would be absolutely contraindicated in? These are absolutely contraindicated in renal failure. As I told you, water soluble drugs are contraindicated in cases of renal failure. Moving further now, beta blockers are contraindicated in conditions known as A, B, C, D. So beta blockers have many side effects. So they are contraindicated in conditions known as A, B, C, D. First, A goes for asthma. So please remember, asthma mein it can lead to bronchoconstriction and can worsen the symptoms. So A goes for also A goes for AV block. A also goes for AV block. Yaad rakh lena. Then B goes for bradycardia. B goes for B goes for? C goes for? CHF. Congestive heart failure. Important point. Very good. But beta blockers are contraindicated in which type of CHF? Acute CHF. Beta blockers are contraindicated in which CHF? And used in chronic CHF. Important baat hai. Congestive heart failure ki agar hum baat kare. In acute CHF mein beta blockers are? Acute CHF mein beta blockers are? Acute CHF mein beta blockers are? And chronic CHF mein beta blockers are? Used or indicated. Yaad rakhna. And last D goes for? Diabetes mellitus. Because in diabetes mellitus it would lead to? Masking of symptoms of hypoglycemia. If a patient diabetic insulin ले लिया, उसके बाद अगर उसको hypoglycemia हो रहा है, okay? Usually he will have sweating, okay? He will have dizziness वगैरह. These symptoms are usually masked with beta blockers. Therefore, beta blockers are contraindicated in cases of diabetics because hypoglycemia is much more severe than hyperglycemia. Hyper can be treated, ठीक है? But hypo, अगर patient का sugar brown हो गया, सिधार गया. ठीक है, याद रख लेना. So beta blockers are contraindicated in A, B, C, D. A for asthma and A for asthma and AB block. B for B for C for C for C for acute CHF. C for acute CHF and D for याद रखना. Now I told you third generation beta blockers also have an alpha blocking property. Therefore, they are alpha plus beta blockers. Alpha plus beta blockers. Naam batao drugs kya? Shabash. Labetalol and carvedilol. Yaad rakh lena. Labetalol and carvedilol are alpha plus beta blockers. Which two drugs are alpha plus beta blockers? Which two drugs are alpha plus beta blockers? Labetalol and carvedilol. Yaad rakhna. Labetalol is a drug of choice for hypertension and pregnancy. Important. आगे बात करेंगे CVS में उसके आगे की. पर ये याद रखना alpha plus beta blockers two drugs labet and carve. Okay. अगर beta two second generation beta blockers की बात करनी है तो the cardioselective which selectively act at beta one receptors. Those would be drugs like metoprolol हो गई, acetylcholine हो गई, atenolol हो गई. Cisprolol हो गई, okay, nebivolol हो गई, all these drugs, हाँ, pindolol is a better one, मतलब controversial है थोड़ा उसका, तो इसीलिए normal ones are these, ठीक है, जो commonly cardioselective है. Now tell me, do you guys contraindications तो पढ़ लिया, those are important. Do you guys really want me to give a mnemonic for beta blocker uses? अगर चाहते हो तो दे देता हूँ, नहीं चाहते हो तो दे दो. चलो, because अगर beta blockers के use समझ में आया ना तो easy हो जाएगा. Beta blockers, okay, there would be beta 1 selective blockers and beta 2 selective blockers. Selective beta 1 blockers and selective beta 2 blockers. Selective beta 1 blockers will act on heart. Selective beta 1 blockers will act on and selective beta 2 blockers will act on lungs or any other parts. So beta 1 blockers are used in mnemonic hai classical ham. Beta 1 blockers are used in classical ham. Classical goes for classical angina. Classical goes for? Classical goes for? Classical angina is stable angina. When chest pain occurs at? Exertion or exercise or stress. If chest pain occurs on exertion, exercise or stress, it is which type of angina? Classical or stable angina. Okay, so first indication is classical angina. H for? Hypertension. H for? H for? A for? Arrhythmia. A for and M for myocardial infarction. M for, so these are the indications when beta 1 selective blockers, that is cardioselective beta blockers, can be used. Whereas beta 2 blockers can be used in conditions known as gamete. ठीक है? G for glaucoma. G for A for anxiety. A for M for important है, question आ चुका है. Propranolol is used in cases of migraine. Propranolol is a selective or a non-selective beta blocker? Non-selective beta blocker. Very good. E for shabash. Essential tremors. E for essential tremors. And T for thyrotoxicosis. Thyrotoxicosis ठीक है, थायरोटॉक्सिकोसिस इज अ कॉम्प्लिकेशन ऑफ हाइपरथायरॉयडिज्म और हाइपोथायरॉयडिज्म. हाइपरथायरॉयडिज्म, थायरोटॉक्सिकोसिस इज अ कॉम्प्लिकेशन ऑफ हाइपरथायरॉयडिज्म, याद रखना. तो जल्दी से, सिलेक्टिव बीटा वन ब्लॉकर्स और कार्डियो सिलेक्टिव बीटा ब्लॉकर्स आर यूज्ड इन कंडीशंस क्लासिकल हैम, क्लासिकल फॉर क्लासिकल और स्टेबल एंजाइना. इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट यहाँ पे, बीटा ब्लॉकर्स आर यूज्ड इन केसेस ऑफ क्लासिकल एंजाइना बट कॉन्ट्रा इंडिकेटेड इन केसेस ऑफ वेरियंट और वेसोस्पेसिफिक और प्रिंस मेटल एंजाइना. ठीक है, बीटा ब्लॉकर्स आर यूज्ड इन विच टाइप ऑफ एंजाइना? बीटा ब्लॉकर्स आर यूज्ड इन विच टाइप ऑफ एंजाइना? बट कॉन्ट्रा इंडिकेटेड इन, बट कॉन्ट्रा इंडिकेटेड इन, because in variant prinzmetal or vasospastic angina the chest pain is due to vasospasm of the coronary arteries. ठीक है, याद रखना, important. whereas second one, essential tremors के लिए drug of choice क्या है? beta 2 blocker. drug of choice for essential tremors is usually we use propranolol. drug of choice for essential tremors is, drug of choice for essential tremors is propranolol. ठीक है, propranolol याद रख लो, important वही है. थायरोटॉक्सिकोसिस में यूजुअली प्रोपैनोलोल पे एक क्वेश्चन आया था, एक बार आया था बट पूछा गया था. प्रोपैनोलोल इनहिबिट्स पेरिफेरल कन्वर्जन. पेरिफेरल कन्वर्जन पता है क्या होता है? शाबाश, T4 इज एन अबंडेंट फॉर्म बट काम करने के लिए कौन चाहिए अपने को? T3. देयरफॉर दिस कन्वर्जन इन पेरिफेरी इज नोन एज पेरिफेरल कन्वर्जन व्हेन T4 इज कन्वर्टेड टू T3 फॉर एक्शन. ठीक है, एंड दिस पेरिफेरल कन्वर्जन इज इनहिबिटेड बाय propanolol. This peripheral conversion is inhibited by propanolol. It is also inhibited by propyl thiouracil. ठीक है, कोई इशू नहीं. हाँ, कम अगेन. Usually beta one, क्या differentiate करना तुम्हें? Drug?
Yes. Like
beta two usually it is a non-selective blocker because it has more pronounced action on beta two receptors. ठीक है, as compared to beta 1, it has more pronounced action on beta 2 receptors. ठीक है, याद रख लेना. तो beta 1 selective blockers जो हमने cardio selective भी बोले, nebivolol, acebutolol, atenolol, metoprolol, वो वाले. और beta 2 में सब non-selective drugs अपने. बाकी के जो आते हैं ना, all of them can come in beta 2, propranolol वगैरह. ठीक है, so एक last two lines, punch lines, फिर उसके बाद चले जाना. beta 1 blockers are used in which type of angina? But contraindicated in? Beta blockers are used in which type of CHF? Beta blockers are used in which type of CHF? But contraindicated in? But contraindicated in? With this, thank you for the session. We'll end the session for today. Let's meet.
You are saying what is beta blockers are contraindicated in diabetes mellitus.
Diabetes mellitus.
He can be given metoprolol
because it is more cardio selective. But it has no pronounced action on as such on the beta 2 receptors. Therefore, the masking of hypoglycemic symptoms would be less. Symptoms ki masking hogi yaha bhi, but it would be less pronounced. ठीक है. Therefore, if there is any indication, better drugs to be used in diabetes are for hypertension, post MI hypertension. ACE inhibitors. याद रख लेना, ACE inhibitors are the best drug to be used in diabetic patients for hypertension. ठीक है, but if in any case there is a contraindication, yeah, post MI also. But if there is any contraindication, then you can offer ACE inhibitors. Then you can use metoprolol, which is a very cardio selective drug. ठीक है, if at any time you need to use it. Otherwise, to mostly it is contraindicated. ठीक है. I hope this session was fruitful. और ये बताओ, if we need to speed up in the next sessions, इस तरह से चलेगा तो चलेगा. Pharma will be completed maximum in 3 or 4 sessions like this. Because अभी general और ANS ही बड़ा topic है. इसके बाद we'll have systemic, mostly drug of choice या mechanism of action या important side effect ही discuss होंगे बस. ठीक है? चल. Next my session would be pharma. I'll continue. I'll complete pharma. Topics would be CVS, CNS and endo. CBS, CNS and Endo. ठीक है?